गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. सो टुडे सेमिनार टॉपिक इज मॉडिफाइड गेट एबनॉर्मेलिटी रेटिंग स्केल. सो द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ सेमिनार इज एट द एंड ऑफ सेमिनार स्टूडेंट्स विल एबल टू नो अबाउट व्हाट इज GARSM स्केल, इट्स डोमेन, इंटरप्रिटेशन एंड द रेफरेंसेस. सो द इंट्रोडक्शन इज द GARS वॉज डिजाइंड टू प्रोवाइड अ सिंपल क्लिनिकल असेसमेंट ऑफ गेट एबनॉर्मेलिटीज. वैलिडिटी ऑफ GARS इज 0.968. The GARSM consisted of 7 items and was derived from the original GARS by Vansorgen et al. In 1996. Independently rated the subjects gait according to 16 variables using a 4-point scale, which includes 0 is normal, 1 is mildly impaired, 2 is moderately impaired, 3 is severely impaired. The GARS was calculated by summing each of the individual variables. The higher score signifies a more impaired gait. The developers of GARS suggest that the original 16-item scale be streamlined to 7 items by eliminating items that appear to demonstrate little difference between the group of followers and non-followers. The second was appear to be difficult to rate visually. Third is generally had the lowest inter-rater reliability, and the fourth is were redundant with other variables. So now the modified version has 7 domains, which are variability, guardiness, staggering, foot contact, hip ROM, shoulder extension, and arm heel strike synchronomy. Interpretation: the distance walked was approximately 76 meters, that is 25 feet in each direction, for the total distance of about 152 meters. Each of the 7 items of GARSM was scored on the criteria based rating scale, that is 0 to 3, reported by the original GARS. The total GARSM score is the sum of 7 individual items, and the total score represent a rank ordering of risk of falling based on the number of gait abnormalities recognized and the severity of any abnormality identified. The GARSM provides a simple way of directly observing and documenting abnormalities of gait, which may be useful in guiding intervention to reduce the risk of recurrent falls. The score of more than 9 indicates the fall risk. So this is the modified version of GARS scale, which includes the 7 domains and is score like 0, 1, 2 and 3. So the first domain is variability, a measure of inconsistency and arrhythmicity of stepping and arm movement. So 0 is fluid and predictable paced movement. 1 is occasional interruption, which is less than 25% of the time. 2 is unpredictability of rhythm. 3 is random timing of limb movement. So the video has been taken in all the direction, and this domains is checked, and the scoring is calculated, and the total score is a sum, and which include the risk of fall. This is a recent advance which says that the individual with conversion disorder has a neurological symptom that are not identified by an underlying organic cause. So the conversion disorder patients have been taken, and the GARS modified scale have been taken in those patients, and the result was found. So the finding was GARS score provide an objective measure upon which the treatment effect can be assessed. This is a reference from where the scale has been taken. Thank you.